A very good morning to all my dear children. Welcome to St. Michael's e-learning classes. My name is Francis sir. And my dear children, today we will solve the question answers, fill in the blanks, etc. of chapter number 9 of social science or standard 5. And the name of the chapter number 9 is temperate climate. So let's begin solving the question answers, fill in the blanks, etc. First we come to A, fill in the blanks. Dash is the most prominent feature of the temperate zone. So the answer is moderate climate. Moderate climate is the most prominent feature of the temperate zone. Question number 2. Temperate zones have dash climate and dash diurnal range of temperature. So we have two fill in the blanks in question number 2. The first is moderate and the second is large. That is, temperate zones have moderate climate and large diurnal range of temperature. Let's see question number 3. In the northern hemisphere, the temperate zone experiences dash type of climate. So the answer is continental type of climate. Now we come to question number 4. Dash is an important nutrient rich fodder grass. So the answer is alfalfa. Alfalfa is an important nutrient rich fodder grass. Question number 5. Coniferous forests spread across the dash belt in Canada. So the answer is taiga. Now we come to B. Match the following. The first is pampas. So the answer, the match the following for question number 1 pampas is South America. Now we come to question number 2. Prairie. So the match the following, the answer for prairie is North America. Now we come to question number 3. Wealth. The answer to this is South Africa. Then we come to question number 4. Down. And the answer to the question number 4 down is Australia. Excuse me. Next we come to question number 5. Steel. And the answer to this is Asia. Now we see question number C. That is write true for two sentences and F for four sentences. So let's begin. Question number 1. Temperate climate spreads across most of the continents in the world. So the answer to this is number 1, true. Question number 2. Temperate zone has an extreme climate. So the answer is false. Question number 3. Temperate grasslands are known as prairies in North America. So the answer is true. Question number 4. Alfalfa is a weed that grows commonly in the prairies and the pampas. So the answer is F, false. Next we come to question number 5. Temperate grasslands support extensive farming. So the answer is true. Now we will come to question number D. Answer the following in few words. Question number 1. Which is the main factor that determines the amount of rainfall that temperate regions receive? So the answer to this question is, depending upon the distance from the sea, temperate regions receive moderate to low rainfall. Now we see question number 2. Name any 5 temperate grasslands in the world. So the answer is prairies, pampas, steppes, savanna and wells are 5 temperate grasslands in the world. Question number 3. Name any 5 animal species found in the temperate grasslands. So the answer is mustang, coyote, prairie dog, rattlesnake and hawk are the 5 animal species found in the temperate grasslands. Now we see question number 4. Name the tribes inhabiting the temperate regions. So the answer is Khoi Khoi, San and Bantu tribes, Kurds, Turk and Mongolian tribes inhabit the temperate regions. Now we see question number 5. Why is the temperate region granary of the world? A very important question. So the answer is, the temperate region is known as granary of the world because wheat, maize, barley, rye and oats are largely grown in this region. Now we will come to question number E, that is, answer the following in detail. So let's see question number 1. Describe the general feature of a temperate climate. So the answer to this question is, temperate zone has a moderate climate. The weather is neither too hot nor too cold. Depending upon the distance from the sea, temperate regions receive moderate to low rainfall. Temperate climate has several variations. Some types of climate found in this zone are Mediterranean, maritime, subtropical, etc. Now we see question number 2. Why does the climate vary from severe to moderate in the northern and southern hemisphere? So the answer is, some areas of the temperate region in the northern hemisphere experience a continental type of climate. This type of climate is characterized by cold winters and hot and humid summers. This type of climate prevails when the land is away from any water body. In the southern hemisphere, the grasslands are spread along the coast. Proximity to the sea means that climate in this region is moderate. Now we'll see question number 3. List the important features of temperate vegetation. So the answer is, the vegetation of the temperate region consists of short grass, thorny bushes and shrubs. Grass in those regions vary according to length, season and variety. They grow tall in prairies and short in steppes. They grow thick in summers, become green in spring and dry out in autumn. Their growth slows in winter, especially in the northern hemisphere. Now we see question number 4. Why is extensive farming carried out in the temperate grasslands? So the answer is, temperate wells are well populated. Its favorable climate and uninterrupted plains supports extensive farming. Large areas of pampas, prairies and steppes have been converted into fields. Wheat, maize, barley, rye and oats are largely grown in these regions. Now we will see the last question of this chapter. Question number 5. How popular is pastoral farming in the temperate regions? So the answer is, the fertile pastures in the temperate regions support a flourishing cattle and sheep rearing industry. In Argentina, this industry is an integral part of its culture. Cowboys, also known as gauchos in Argentina. Estancia is the huge and splendid pastoral farm. Gauchos are responsible for the management of these farms. So in this way, my children, we have completed the question answers, fill in the blanks, etc. of chapter number 9 of Social Science or Standard 5. In our next class, we will solve the question answers, fill in the blanks of chapter number 11, not 10. Chapter number 10 is not included in your second syllabus. So till then, write the answers of this particular chapter in your notebook and study.